فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ
فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ
فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is lecture number 22 from the Right Believe series, semester 2, lecture number 14. And today, inshallah, we're going to talk about al-naqid al-khamis min nawaqid al-Islam, the fifth nullifier of Islam, which is من أبغض شيئا مما جاء به الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم ولو عمل به فقد كفر. Whoever dislikes anything, شيئاً, anything, any of the teachings of Islam, he has disbelieved. والدليل, the evidence, قول الله تعالى في سورة محمد, the verse in سورة محمد, ذلك بأنهم كَرِهُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. This is because they hated, they disliked what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, has brought down, and as a result of this, their deeds became fruitless or wasted. وحبوط العمل, يعني whatever you do as a Muslim, when you lose it, only two reasons, كفر or شرك, all your deeds, يعني سبحان الله من رحمة الله, out of the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, أبو نص أن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. That when you commit a sin, if you do a good deed, that good deed erases the sin. أقم الصلاة طرفي النهار وزلفا من الليل إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says to معاذ بن جبل اتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها. Follow a sin with a good deed, the good deed will erase the sin. Now when you do a righteous deed and then you commit a sin, does the sin erase the hasana? You see, we said that when you commit a sin, and you do any righteous deed, that righteous deed, that hasana, that you get out of that righteous deed, erases what? The sin. Now if you do a hasana, a good deed, and then you commit a sin, does that sin erases the hasana? Huh? Only one sin does this. Shirk wal kufr. Shirk wal ridda. وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. It was revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all the messengers and prophets before you, that if you commit shirk, all your deeds will be wasted. Also, الرِّدَّة, that you come out of the fold of Islam, causes you to lose all your deeds when you leave Islam. And this is the evidence right here, that if you dislike anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down, it causes you to do what? To go out of the fold of Islam. And as a result of this, huh? ذلك بأنهم كرهوا ما أنزل الله فأحبط أعماله. So their deeds became wasted because of what? What did they do? What did they do? They disliked that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to His Messenger. And this took them out of the fold of Islam. وَمَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَيَمُتْ وَهُوَ كَافِرٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. الرِّدَّة, that when you come out of the fold of Islam, all the deeds that you done, all the good deeds are wasted, fruitless. This is the evidence. Normally when it's very hard to comprehend, you will find a lot of evidence that if you dislike anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, dislike it, resent it. I don't like that. Huh? The hijab. I don't like that hijab business. You know, all the religion is good for me, but that hijab is, I don't like it. The beard. And inshallah, I'm going to shed light on this, between being lazy, having weak iman ضعيف, that you're not fulfilling the command, and بغض الشرع والدين, polygamy, right? Marrying more than one wife. How many Muslims these days, يا أخي الإسلام ده جميل جدا, it's good, بس this issue is, it's embarrassing, it's, I just don't like it. I don't want to talk about it. Ages. That type. Yahi, when Islam speaks about the Jews and the Christians, it's a little bit yani hard. I just don't like this piece. Don't like the cutting hands, flogging. Yani, I just don't like اللحية. The beard. All the religion is good except that beard thing. It's just too much. Resenting anything that Allah has revealed takes you out of the fold of Islam. Now we want to say one thing quickly here. What do we mean by Allah revealed? What? Our religion is made of what? Quran and Sunnah, both. So if you resent the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's the same ruling. If you resent anything in the Quran, it's the same ruling. So when we talk about resenting anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, we're talking about what? Both what? Quran and Sunnah, because both are what? Revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بس القرآن, the Quran وحي, words and meanings. السنة وحي, meanings, and the wording was left to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do it in his own. وما ينطق عن الهوى. وما ينطق عن الهوى. He does not speak out of desire. Whether whatever he speaks is the Quran or whatever he speaks is the Sunnah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Both. Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhuma. At one stage, كما عند Muslim, he used to record whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say. The Qurayshi told him, why are you writing everything that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says? Rasulullah bashar, the Messenger of Allah is a human being. يَتَكَلَّمُ فِي الرِّضَى وَالْغَضَبِ. He speaks when he is upset, when he speaks when he is okay. Don't write everything. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam noted that he stopped writing. He asked him why. He said, نَهَتْنِي قُرَيْشِ. The Qurayshi told me, don't record everything. قَالَ لَهُ اكْتُبْ. قَالَ لَهُ اكْتُبْ. He said to him, write. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. By the one in whose hand my soul is. مَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ إِلَّا حَقٍّ. Everything that comes out at any time is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَدِّ السُنَّةِ هَذَا يَا إِخْوَى شَيْءٍ. مَذْهَبْ رَدِّ السُنَّةِ هَذَا. The tendency to reject the sunnah, madhab qadim, لعلمك يعني, madhab qadim, من زمان, من الأزل. يعني سبحان الله, أنا أقرأ هذا الحديث وكأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني already was informed that time will come when people will reject his sunnah. حديث المقداد, المقدام ابن معد يكرب رضي الله عنه, كما عند الترمذي, he says صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألا إني أوتيت الكتاب ومثله معه. I was given الكتاب اللي هو إيه؟ What is الكتاب؟ القرآن and the like of القرآن. شوف, ألا يوشك رجل شبعان على أريكته. Time will come when somebody with a big belly reclining on his couch, يأتيه الأمر مني. The command comes to him from the sunnah. يقول له, افعل هذه, do this. Why? قال رسول الله, the messenger said, صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول, no, علينا بالقرآن. Let's just follow the Quran. فما وجدنا فيه من حلال حللناه. وما وجدنا فيه من حرام حرمنا. We just follow the Quran. Leave the Sunnah. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. سبحان الله. Don't we have a whole sect in the Ummah called the Quraniyun? يعني القرآن, أنا بقول لك لفظ القرآنيون هذا مجازا. يعني we're saying Quran. أنت if you truly a Qurani, لو كنت قرآني لاتبعت السنة. يعني احنا بنقول قرآنيين كده عشان هم ايه, they chose that name. يعني we're saying that they are Quranites because they chose that name. But if they are a true follower of the Quran, they would have followed the Sunnah. Then what's in the Quran? وما آتاكم, isn't that in the Quran? وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه. Whatever the messenger commands you to do, do. Whatever the messenger bans you, do not do. Isn't that in the Quran? So if you follow the Quran, then you should that should take you where? To the Sunnah. If you are really a Qur'ani, but see, we say Qur'ani, but this is the name they choose to go by. سبحان الله يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم listen to this hadith just to show you that حتى السنة even the sunnah that he says he receives it the same exact way that he receives the Quran. الحديث معروف حديث ثوبان في السنن says إن روح القدس نفث في روعي. شوف. The Holy Spirit. Who's the Holy Spirit? جبريل عليه السلام. نفث. Breathed inside me. That's not Quran. أن نفسا لن تموت حتى تستكمل أجلها ورزقها. This is what Jibreel breathed into him. No soul will die until it will receive its full portion and it will live the time which is ordained for. Yani you're not gonna die unless you receive all your provision. Rizqak. Rizq ta'ak will come to you. And you will live the time you're supposed to live. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. Deal with Allah now, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained this a long time ago. Now deal with Allah. اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ and seek your provision from lawful means. اسمع. وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّكُمْ استِبْطَاءُ الرِّزْقِ أَن تَطْلُبُوهُ بِمَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not let the delay in your provision. Your provision is not coming. Your rizq is taking its time. Don't try now to be hasty and try to seek it from unlawful means. فَإِنَّمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Whatever Allah has for you can only obtain through His obedience. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُدْرَكُ مَا عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِطَاعَتِهِ. فالشاهد يا إخوة نحن أيوة we want to establish something that when we say ذلك بأنهم كرهوا, this is because they dislike, they resented, they hated what Allah brought down. We mean what? What Allah brought down, we mean what? Quran and ما تقوليش في السنة, ده في السنة. I don't like this one, it's في السنة وبعدين في السنة مش مهم. لا, both are what? Revelation from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Very quickly, what is the reason that when you resent, when you dislike something that is in the Quran and the Sunnah, you dislike it? Again, I wanna make sure that you understand this. We're not talking about you being lazy, you slacking, having weak faith to fulfill this. لا. We're talking about the resentment. Man, I don't like the salah. Oh, and you're probably going to be praying too. But I don't like the salah. You know, your heart is, we're talking about the action of what? Resentment, like and dislike, love and hate is the act of what? Action of what? Of the heart. And this is the quality of who? This is the attribute of who? منافق. شوف المنافق, شوف المنافق. وما منعهم أن تقبل منهم نفقاتهم. They give صدق, but Allah doesn't accept it from them. Why doesn't Allah accept it from them? إلا أنهم كفروا بالله وبرسوله. Inside them they hate Allah and His Messenger. They disbelieve in Allah and His Messenger. Inside them, and they're giving sadaqah. Look, because of that hate. وَلَا يَأْتُونَ الصَّلَاةَ إِلَّا وَهُمْ كُسَالَى. He comes to the salah lazy.
he doesn't like it, he doesn't, but he has to be there.
وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَ إِلَّا وَهُمْ كَارِهُونَ.
And he gives it while he's hating to give. The issue here, why? What is the wisdom? This matter is tremendous in Islam. One reason. Because we're required to love Allah and His Messenger. And I will like that in akad. It's actually a requirement. A requirement. It's actually mandatory that you love Allah and His Messenger. You must love them. وشوف when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the generation who will replace those who leave Islam. شوف يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَنْ يَرْتَدَّ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ. Oh, you believe, whoever leaves Islam, look, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ. Huh? Allah will bring another generation who will do what? يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. Now, if you love Allah and His Messenger, a branch of that love, that you love what they bring to you. Is that correct or what? وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. If someone whom you love, a human being, sends you a letter, sends you a message, don't you read it over and over again? Reflect upon it. And what did they mean here? What did they say here? But somebody that you don't like sends you a message, sends you a letter. What do you do? Man, again, what does he want? It's disgusting. شوف انت الصفات. وإذا ما هو شوف الموضوع ده خطير جدا. This issue is very serious and a lot of Muslims fall into it, but we have to be careful here. وهم لا يدرون. كثير من المسلمين بيقع في هذا الموضوع while he does not know. شوف هذه. وإذا ما أنزلت سورة. Look at the end of سورة التوبة. When a chapter is revealed. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولِ. Those people who resent. أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ هَذِهِ إِيمَانًا. الصورة دي يعني عملت لك إيه؟ Did this surah increase your إيمان؟ ولا لها صم في اللازم؟ عايز يقول يعني كده. I don't think it's important. When a chapter is revealed, وَإِذَا مَا أُنْزِلَتْ سُورَةً. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولِ. Those people who hate what is being brought down, they will say to one another, أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ هَذِهِ إِيمَانِ. It did not increase you at all. It did not help you. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَهُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. Look, وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضُ. Lowell hate. They hate Allah. They hate His Messenger. And they hate what is coming down from there. فزادتهم رجسا الى رجسهم. انت شوف الايه المعنى الثاني. They will be sitting with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Look at this verb. واذا ما انزلت سوره. Again, another scenario here. And when a chapter is revealed, they will be sitting in the crowd. نظر بعضهم الى بعض. They would stare at one another. So the Sahaba is sitting and ايه, and enjoying the Quran, learning, loving it. Man, this is good. We ask Alunak and they ask the Messenger about this. And they're sitting there. نظر بعضهم إلى بعض. They look at them. هل يراكم من أحد? Let's go. Let's go. And they leave. وإذا ما أنزلت سورة نظر بعضهم إلى بعض هل يراكم من أحد ثم انصرفوا. صرف الله قلوبهم بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون. The point that I'm trying to make here is a very important point, which is what? A branch of loving Allah, loving His Messenger is what? That you love what? What they brought to you. Al-Qur'an wa Sunnah. Al-Qur'an هذا مش كلام الله. Al-Qur'an مش كلام الله. Isn't the Qur'an is the word of Allah? صحيح؟ طيب. Do you love Allah? Allah is sending you a message. Shouldn't you love it? When you resent it, when you hate it, it's a branch that you have not established that love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. Subhanallah, يعني المنافقين يا إخوة, the hypocrites in particular, يعني, they would be doing the acts of the Muslims, but yet is not accepted because they hate Allah and His Messenger, they hate the Quran, they hate the Sunnah. But look at the other hand, and I was reflecting upon this today, which is out of this world. Just to show you, the issue has nothing to do with your outward commitment. I want to stress this. Hadith Umar, al-Sahabi, who used to be brought في البخاري, hadith, he used to be brought to the Prophet ﷺ drunk all the time. He gets drunk all the time. They bring him to the messenger, flog him, he goes back. At one stage, while they are flogging him, some of the Sahaba said, La'anahu Allah, may Allah curse him. How often he comes and he gets flogged and he doesn't want to leave this. You know what the Prophet ﷺ says? La tal'anu. Don't curse him. إِنَّهُ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. He loves Allah and His Messenger. شوف. Meanwhile, he's what? He's slacking. He's lazy. He's weak. But look at the other hand. I wanted to compare the other end of this. شوف الصورة الثانية الذي المنافق, the hypocrite. بيصلي. تلاقيه في الصف الأول. You will see him in the first row. وبينفق. بس his acts are not accepted. Why? Because inside his heart what? يبغض الله ورسوله. المنافق يبغض. The hypocrite resents Allah and His Messenger. They don't like Allah and His Messenger. ولذلك سبحان الله, يعني I want to tell you, رب العالمين, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually given a special status to the disbeliever. He made him in a higher, in a better. They are both in hell, يعني, but شوف, إن المنافقين, where? Where? في الدرك الأسفل من النار. In the lowest level. That means الكافر, اللي هو الكافر الأصلي, the one who tells you, listen, I'm a disbeliever. أنا ما بؤمنش بالدين بتاعك. He's in a better what? Why? Because المنافق, the hypocrite, deceives Allah and His Messenger. In the sense, يعني, they think that they are deceiving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They deceive the believers. Yes, they pretend that they are Muslims. They say kalimatul Islam, they pray, they fast, they are amongst you. Inside them, they hate you. They hate Islam, they hate the Quran, they hate the Sunnah. And they can't wait for a chance to bring the deen down. We're talking about those. فيعني سبحان الله الأمر جد خطير. But let me first give examples, because this will make things crystal clear for you. But first, we must differentiate. لا بد من التفريق بين مجرد الترك We must differentiate between you not following the commands, ترك الأمر يعني اجتناب النهي وامتثال الأمر. You leave this because if you're lazy, you're slacking, your iman is weak, your nafs is stronger, you need to do more jihad against your nafs, and between you hating the command, resenting the command. Here is an example. امرأة لا تلبس الحجاب. A woman who does not wear hijab. A Muslim woman who does not wear her hijab. But she believes that hijab is mandatory. تؤمن أن الحجاب واجب. Mandatory. ولا تجحد فرضيته. And she does not reject the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained it upon her as a Muslim woman. ولا تبغض نزوله في القرآن. And she does not resent the verses in the Quran regarding the hijab. And she does not try to manipulate the verse. يعني how many Muslim women, they tell you the hijab is not in the Quran. شايف؟ تيجي تقول لها يا أختي تبتعالي في آية في الأحزاب وفي آية في النور. There is a verse in سورة النور and there is a verse in سورة الأحزاب. وبعدين السنة وحي. مش تقول لا 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 القرآن. تبتعالي في سورة النور. ها؟ وقل للمؤمنات يغضضن من أبصارهن ويحفظن فروجهن. The long verse, half a page in سورة النور. وده verse in سورة الأحزاب يا أيها النبي. قل لأزواجك ونسائك وبنات المؤمنين يدنين عليهن. What do you do with this يا أختي؟ لا. It doesn't mean that. It doesn't mean the hijab. So she doesn't try to manipulate what? The text. وإيه when she sees, look at this now. I just want to tell you that what goes through their mind, the psycho, نفسيات شوف, I'm talking about this. And when she sees a sister wearing hijab, يا سلام. I wish I can be like her. تتمنى أنها ترتدي الحجاب. The other one when she sees somebody wearing the hijab, تخلف. Look at this. Backward. Jailing women. Imprisoning women. So what is this? Can do this. A sister like this. And she's always going between those two feelings. Huh? Feeling guilty for not wearing hijab. And subhanallah, this one, she's under the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah could forgive her if she does like this. يعني إذا ماتت هذه المرأة هكذا الله يغفر لها. قد يغفر لها. هي تحت رحمة الله. هي مرتكبة لكبيرة. She's committing a major sin. Not wearing the hijab. It's a major sin not to wear the hijab. But هي تحت رحمة الله. تحت مشيئة الله سبحانه وتعالى. But look at the other one. Hijab. I hate this hijab. It's in the Quran. I hate it. We should not be doing it. It's backward. هذه تكفر. تخرج من الملة. سبحان الله. This one gets out of Islam. Of course, if she has the knowledge about what she's doing, if she does not do this out of faulty interpretation, and if she's not doing this out of error and being forced. والله يا إخوة, you probably heard me saying this before over and over again. ها؟ هذه المرأة, I heard this woman. يعني شوف هذه. شوف. Egyptian one. لو أتاني. المرأة تقول هذا الكلام. This Egyptian woman says what? لو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أتاني وقال لي ارتدي الحجاب لقلت له لا يا رسول الله. شوف الكلام. If the messenger of Allah comes and asks me to wear the hijab, I will tell him no يا messenger of Allah. هذه ال resentment. انت شايف البغضاء. وبخاصة يا إخوة الآن في قضايا النساء. يعني I want to tell you this is a very crucial issue, especially amongst بسموهم عنا النخبة. We call them النخبة, the chosen people in the Muslim world now. The engineers, the doctors, اللي هم الايه highly educated in the field of دنيا. بتقول له كده اقرا لي كده, خد يا خد يا دكتور, يا دكتور لو سمحت يا دكتور القران اهو, اقرا لي كده البقره كده الله يخليك اقراها لي كده. ها ما يعرف يقرا القران, ما he doesn't know how to recite the Quran, his knowledge of the deen is what, zero. When you speak about these issues, don't say that. I think a couple of weeks back, I explained hadith Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said regarding having the best treasure. تعرفين الآية اللي هي في سورة التوبة, that gold and silver and so forth is the treasure. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said something regarding this verse. He said, خير ما اكتنز المسلم, the best thing that you can have of a treasure at home, الزوجة الصالحة في بيتك, that you have a righteous wife in your house. And I spoke about the qualities of the righteous wife and the fact that she should be at home, and إذا نظر إليها أصرت وإذا غاب عنها, if he looks at her, you cannot imagine the amount of, Sheikh, we thought that we are in Afghanistan and we're having mullah here giving khutbas. هو يعني الدين حيختلف من أفغانستان لدنفر يعني, ولا حنغير الدين عشان احنا في دنفر يعني, ولا مش فاهم يعني, when we come to Denver now we have to change the religion يعني, ولا ما هذه مش أحكام شرعية ولا. Why resenting this? I am 100% positive that these brothers don't even know the magnitude of what they are saying. They don't know. They don't know it. They don't know that this actually can take them out of the fold of Islam. They don't know it. They do this out of ignorance, especially the issue of women, the inequality. تيجي انت مثلا ايه موضوع الايه الميراث المرأة مثلا. ما هو ايه, the West did a wonderful job in the sense, يعني in the negative way. Islam is being unfair to the women. Islam is being unfair to the women. Islam is being unfair to the women. Islam is being unfair. انت عارف repeat the message all the time, make you believe it. فتيجي انت تقول ايه في الميراث, talking about inheritance, للذكر مثل حظ الأنثيين. The male gets one, the female gets half. يجي this secular كان you know physician resent, يكره, ما هو يبغض هذا, وإيه يتمنى ألا تقرأ هذه, he wishes that you don't recite this verse, you wish that, he wishes that you don't even mention it in a khutbah, he wishes that it's removed from the Quran. ليه؟ لأنه inside him هو كره التشريع. تيجي تقول له إيه شهادة المرأة؟ تعرف عندنا موضوع تاني يعني, there is another issue which is very interesting, which is what اللي هي الإيه, the testimony يعني witnessing اللي هو الشهادة. فإن لم يكون رجلين فرجل, ده دي قرآن يا أخي. Isn't that Quran? You need two witnesses, males. If you cannot find two men, then a man and two women. Oh, ya Sheikh, ya Allah. He wishes this goes out of. And wallahi, when you recite these verses, when you bring the subject up, you could tell in their faces. You could tell in their face. تلاقيه شايل كده. شوف وحتى الله القرآن صور هذا وإذا تتلى عليهم آياتنا بينات تعرف في وجوه الذين كفروا المنكر يكادون يسطون بالذين يتلون عليهم آياتنا. And when you recite to them these verses, you could tell in their eyes. قاعد كده مقفز لك كده. Does like this to you. He's about to jump on you. Stop. I don't want to hear this. I don't want to talk about it. لا ما ينفع. أصل ده تشريع. ده دين. ده دين. وبعدين رب العالمين وضع هذا. Allah is the one who revealed this. قل أأنتم أعلم أم الله؟ من يعلم هنا؟ Who created? Huh? Who created? He knows us. He knows what fixes us. He knows what takes care of us. There is a wisdom behind every single ruling in the Sharia. Now the fact that you're unable to grasp it, you're unable to get it, it's your problem. يا إخوة والله عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه says يا أيها الناس يعني he made that statement يا أيها الناس اتهموا الرأي في الدين statement اتهموا الرأي في الدين فلو رأيتني يوم الحديبية وأبي جندل وأنا أرد أمر رسول الله he's talking about the story of الحديبية I shared it with you in خطبة الجمعة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم accepted humiliating conditions to establish peace with the disbelievers. You know when they went for Umrah and they were stopped? Huh? You know the story, right? وبعدين سهيل بن عمرو came huh? and they put together a treaty, a truce, صلح يعني. اكتب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Who's الرحمن الرحيم هذا؟ شوف سهيل بن عمرو رضي الله عنه. He was not a Muslim at the time. Who's الرحمن الرحيم? We don't know who's الرحمن الرحيم. We don't know Allah called الرحمن. اكتب باسمك اللهم. طب between محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. سهيل بن عمرو jumps and says, By Allah, if I know that you are, if I believe that you are the messenger of Allah, I would not be believing you. I don't believe that you're the messenger of Allah. شوف. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وايبت محمد بن عبد الله. Here is the interesting piece. The interesting piece. Look at this now. If a Muslim comes from Mecca accepting Islam, the Muslims have to turn him back. And if a Muslim leaves Islam and goes to Mecca, the disbelievers don't have to take him back. شاف الشرط؟ شوف as they are writing this the son of Suhail his name is Abu Jandal Ya Allah he came in his chains his father actually chained him tied him, shackled him he came walking 37 miles on his feet on these chains you know when you're chained how you walk walking he escaped and he threw himself amongst the Muslims rescue me, take me Suhail ibn Amr looks at the Prophet this is the first one you have to turn otherwise no peace this is the first one Rasul sallallahu looks at him and says ya Rasul, ya, leave this to me please let this one go وبعدين bear in mind that الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم did a favor to Suhail. Suhail was one of the people who was imprisoned after Badr. كان من أسرى بدر. وعمر كان عايز رضي الله عنه he wanted to take his teeth off. دعني أكسر ثنيته. In order not to speak anymore about you, Messenger of Allah. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم is reminding him يا سهيل يعني let this one go please this one go because he sees the attitude of the Sahaba I said no he has to go back otherwise no peace take him back look at Umar عمر اهو شوف ما هو الرسول did the messenger do all of this out of desire ولا كان commands كان وحي ولا ايه what was that what was that how did the messenger do these things based on what طيب عمر اهو عمر and عمر by the way was representing a lot of sahaba يعني عمر was not doing this just on his own عمر actually was expressing the feelings of a lot of the sahaba what is going on here we're humiliated we don't deserve that عمر had the guts to go out there and he goes there, so, شوف 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 يا رسول الله O messenger of Allah ألسنا على الحق look at this ألسنا على الحق قال بلى Aren't we in the truth? قال بلى. وهم على الباطل. Yes. وهم على الباطل. And they are in falsehood. بلى. Yes, they are. Aren't we on the truth? Yes, we are. Aren't they on falsehood? Yes. لما نعطي الدنيا في ديننا? He's questioning what? الوحي. Questioning the command. Why do we give up like this? Why do we give in like? Why are we being humiliated? Why do we have to go through this? قال يا عمر He said يا عمر إني رسول الله I'm the messenger of Allah وهو ناصري And he will give me victory عمر was so furious So furious So upset He went to Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه He asked him the same exact questions And subhanAllah, he received the same exact answers. Typical answers. فعمر is saying after that, شوف subhanAllah, I want to tell you something. As they are marching back to Mecca, I'm sorry, to Medina. إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا We have granted you A great victory. This was a great victory. فعمر is telling us what? أيها الناس. Look what he's saying. أيها الناس. اتهموا الرأي في الدين. Always accuse your opinion once it comes to the deen, once it comes to the religion. Don't think that your opinion is right. Always accuse. If you would just have seen me the day of Hudaybiyah, I'm talking with the messenger in that manner. And then I found out that was the right thing for the Muslims. Yani, if you're found of numbers, look at this. Al-Hudaybiyah was in what year after Hijrah? What year? Come on, brothers. 6 years. طيب فتح مكة was what one year 8 and حج was what year 10th الحديبية how many Muslims were around the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم 1400 صح الأقوال طب فتح مكة how many 10,000 طب حج 120,000 So we're talking numbers here, ولا إيه? You like numbers, right? فتح ولا مش فتح? نصر ولا مش نصر? ما هو عمر يقول لك إيه? Don't admire your opinion about the text. Accuse your opinion. عمر, by the way, in one of the wording of this hadith said, I still fast and give صدقة for Allah to forgive me what I done on this day. ما زلت أصوم وأتصدق حتى يغفر الله الله لي ما فعلت مع الرسول في هذا اليوم يعني feeling guilty يعني. Oh. You find these brothers yes listen they are A plus in medicine he is a doctor very successful doctor he is a very successful engineer he is a very successful IT guy he is a but zero in the knowledge of the deen His brain, his mind got contaminated by the secular West approach regarding the religion. When you bring up these issues in front of him, quality of women, والكواليتي والمساواة والرجل والمرأة يبغض مشكلة. I'm telling you, a lot of these brothers, they don't know that actually what they are doing takes them out of Islam, because you're resenting. ذلك بأنهم كرهوا ما أنزل الله فأحبط أعمالهم. يعني last year I recall this in Hajj. The travel agent wanted to, one of these really, I think the guy is like assistant of Obama somewhere or some, he's in the cabinet somewhere, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. But he's having, يعني, listen, he's a guru in his field. ما هو انت تعب, ما هو شوف الايه, ما هو العقل, ما هو شوف يقول لك ايه العقل, ما هو انت يا اخي in India you see scientist, في الهند عالم, a scientist top of the line in his field, وبعدين when he walks out he sees boob of a cow, huh? He goes and he what, هو عالم سبحان العقل. شوف العقل, ما هو انت عارف في الهند بعضهم يعبدون البقر, you know that in India some of them they worship what, for them the boo, you know the boob, it's called boob, right? The dung, dung, the dung of a cow is what, is holy, sacred, the urine and the dung. So they, so this scientist who Babu Guru is in the top high level guy is walking down the street and the cow urinates, shh, barakah. طب انت يعني how did you come up with this? I just want to tell you it doesn't, يعني you could be off here and totally off here. The travel agent, يعني he wanted to do him something. I didn't know. يعني he plans these things every year. He always every year comes up with something for me. He had me to be his roommate. حطني في الغرفة معه. يعني he said, hey, let's see what happens here, what develops. Sheikh Karim with top of the line, يعني علماني بطريقة عجيبة. فطبعاً the first day, يعني I'm taking it easy, just, you know, going about my business. I started feeling that he wanted to talk, يعني. I normally try, يعني at the very beginning I listen, so to know what I'm dealing with. Somehow he got into that thing, I don't like these speakers, خطبة الجمعة. He lives in Washington DC. I don't like these speakers for خطبة الجمعة. They go out there and they say, اليهود والنصارى كفار ومش عارف ايه. قلت يا ليلة بيضا, احنا بدأنا من لا انت موضوعك طويل. The Jews and the Christians. يعني he doesn't like the fact that we say that the Jews and the Christians are disbelievers. يعني فقلت انت ليلتك بيضا, يعني احنا ايه. فيعني براحة كده قلت له, طب يعني انت مش بتؤمن, يعني slowly كده, don't you believe يعني ده قرآن وكده, ده قرآن مش عارف ايه. طب ان ده قرآن, الله said that they are disbelievers, what do you think about that? I said, where? قلت له, طب طب this is easy. لقد كفر الذين قالوا ان الله والمسيح ابن مريم لم يكن الذين كفروا من اهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين. لقد كفر الذين قالوا ان الله ثالث ثلاث. All of these are said, بس يا ما هو, you take one verse and you leave one verse. Huh? ولتجدنهم أقرب مودة للذين آمنوا الذين قالوا إنا نصارى ذلك بأن منهم قسيسين ورهبانا وأنهم لا يستكبرون. And you will find the closest. What about this verse? You didn't leave this verse. You left this verse. And you will find the closest to the Muslims, those who say that we are Christians. Why? Because amongst them there are priests and they are not arrogant. طيب. And he started saying, can you carry on reciting the verse? Because it's not over yet. You see, if we take that verse out, it's out of context. Listen, there is another verse after it. وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ
أعينهم تفيض من الدم يقولون ربنا آمنا فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين. ده دول آمنوا, ده دول أسلموا. You see, you stop there, that the fact that they are priests and they are not arrogant, listen, you stop there. If they stay like this, they are still disbelievers. But look at the next verse. You have to read the next verse. And when they hear what was revealed to the messenger, you will see their eyes flooding with tears, and they will say, Amanna, I'm a Muslim. وَمَا لَنَا لَا نُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَا جَاءَنَا مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَنَطْمَعُ أَنْ يُدْخِلْنَا رَبُّنَا مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الصَّالِحِينَ فَأَثَابَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِمَا قَالُوا جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. ما تكمل. Complete the verses. Oh. I just want to tell you, a lot of them don't have the knowledge. They resent a lot of the things in the Sharia while they don't know the magnitude of what they are doing. Can we take one more example? Huh? One more example? A lot of you don't like me to bring this up. But let me say something, especially for the sisters. This issue would be the issue of the husband marrying more than one wife. بعض المسلمين الآن يقول لك ها وكأنه الموضوع مش موضوع في الدين أبدا. Listen, I'm not encouraging your wives don't come after me. I'm not saying to any of you to go. Huh? السلام عليكم. This is a disclaimer. Stay with your spouse. Don't think about it. It's a lot of trouble. But look at this now. All the women resent that. كل النساء بيكرهوا هذا الموضوع. All women dislike that. Don't think that women like this, by the way. They dislike it. Would that be considered resentment of the Sharia? No. This is called resentment of الطبع. طبيعة المرأة هكذا, the nature of it. But once it comes to the divine command, it's in the religion, it's in the deen, she doesn't have any problem with it. You will find her having no problem with it. The fact that it's in the religion, it's in the deen. But if you resent it being part of the deen, Allah revealed it as a sharia, that is where you go out of Islam. But resent it, like, look, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ huh? وَهُوَ كُرْ. Fighting is prescribed upon you when it is what? Disliked. Disliked, why it's disliked? Because fighting is what? You get killed, you lose your will, so you dislike that. But the fact that fighting or jihad is prescribed in the Sharia, you don't resent that. You don't. So I want to differentiate between كره الطبع وبغض الشرع. That being a human being and certain things, by inclination, you're not gonna like it. But you don't resent it because it's a sharia. You don't resent it because it's a deen. طيب موضوع an issue that you don't like me to speak about all the time. Huh? And I intentionally bring it up. The beard. موضوع اللحية. الموضوع هذا عجيب. عجيب عجيب عجيب. 17 حديث establish اللحية. They establish that beard is mandatory. The four imams يرون وجوبها. مالك وأحمد والشافعي وأبو حنيفة, they see beard is mandatory. وفي إجماع في المسألة. There is a consensus regarding the matter. ونقل هذا الإجماع ابن حزم الظاهري. ابن حزم compiled هذا this consensus. There is a consensus. وما قال عالم من علماء المسلمين بجواز حلق اللحية. أنا أقول لكم no scholar مش says that it's permissible to shave your beard. الاختلاف في مسألتين. The differing is in two issues. دون القبضة ابن عمر, that you could take my beard even doesn't reach to the سبحان الله. Here you go, Jude. So القبضة you could take below that. ابن عمر, if you want to follow ابن عمر, وإن كان الموضوع ده أصلا في الحج فقط, only in حج,
وسعيد بن المسيب ومالك, they said that you could you could do that. But clean shaved, ما أحد قال بهذا الموضوع أبدا. I'm sorry. والله I love you all for the sake of Allah. No question about it. Even if you're clean shaved, I still love you.
طيب تلاقي عندك واحد مسلم الآن, a Muslim. He's shaved, he's not clean. He's not يعني having a beard. He's afraid to face that, because the beard brings challenges. I agree. The beard brings a lot of challenges. It does. At the airport, you're looked upon. And you may go to the special meeting area. Yeah. Who's your sheikh? My sheikh is milkshake. All of them said that. My sheikh is milkshake. Yeah, who's your sheikh? Who they? يعني you face a lot of challenges. يعني it's not. فتلاقي واحد من الناس الرجل لسه يعني his iman is not up there yet. He believes it's mandatory, and he's hoping one day he will have it. Like, exactly like the hijab. And when he sees somebody, MashaAllah, Assalamu alaykum. He loves it. He loves to see it. Shi'ar al-Islam, shi'ar. He loves to see it. But he's afraid to face his family, to face the community. He's still, يعني, his iman. This is under the mercy of Allah. But there are people who say, beard? What is this? What's so important about the beard, man? It's not important. Resenting the commands, resenting the sharia, that type of thing. فنسأل الله العظيم رب العرش الكريم أن يعني one more thing just before I go. Resenting the verses that talks about the Sahaba. It talks about the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah ya ikhwa, ana kunt fi dars out of here, not in that town. And somebody I knew who are Rafidi Shi'i, Rafidi Imami, those people who hate Abu Bakr, Umar, Aisha. They've based their religion in hating the Sahaba. SubhanAllah, I knew this man from a long time. I think, in Florida or somewhere. And we had a very serious conversation. I knew who he is. I was lecturing, I think, in Pittsburgh or somewhere there. And I spotted him in the masjid. SubhanAllah, I came across this hadith Amr ibn al-As. Sahih al-Bukhari. I was delivering the khutbah. Amr ibn al-As is asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, Man ahabbu al-nasi ilayk? Who do you love most? Out of the people. Guess what the Prophet says? What? Aisha. Allah. Amal hakada. مش ده يبغض هذا ما أنزل الله؟ ده يكفر ولا ما يكفر شيء؟ مش ده نص؟ yeah. He didn't like it. He didn't want to hear it. Speak about the virtue of Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman in front of those people. فسر له كده لقد تاب الله على النبي والمهاجرين والأنصار الذين اتبعوه في ساعة العسر. فسر له كده والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعهم بإحسان. قلبه يشيط, يكره, ريزنت. مش يكفر هذا, مش كلامه. ذلك بأنهم كرهوا ما أنزل الله. They hated that which Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed. فأحبط أعمالهم. One more thing, Ikhwa, before I finish here, is مسألة A lot of Muslims these days, they got too much involved into sinning. He's into his toes. Toes or heads? Into his head, in usury, riba. His credit card is skyrocketing. He probably has $50,000-$60,000 and he's paying interest. His house is a mortgage, his car is a mortgage. Totally, in the depth. He comes to Jum'ah, الشيخ يتكلم عن الربا. The Sheikh would talk about what?
لعن الله الربا وآكله وموكله وكاتبه وشاهديه كلهم سواء.
Allah curses usury. The one who receives it, the one who gives it, the one who writes the contract and the two witnesses, they are all equal in the curse. تلاقيه قاعد كده والله. Somebody is opening a liquor store. They tell you that the majority of the owners of liquor stores in America are Muslims. يقول لك كده والله. في إحصائي. تخيل أنت هذا الموضوع؟ يعني أنا والله العظيم موضوع عجيب. يعني when I read this, I معظم ملاك محلات الخمور في أمريكا من المسلمين. تبيجي هذا this person comes and sits in front of you.
لعن الله الخمر. وبعدين once it comes to liquor, how many are being cursed? Anybody knows how many? How many?
10 ولا 9؟ 9 or 10؟ 10. 10. The one who drinks it, the one who sells it, the one who pours it. شوف سبحان الله, once it came to liquor, even the one who transferred, the one who brought it, the waitress, everybody. تيجي تقول له, he resents what? He resents that. أقول لك يا أخي, listen. Always, يا إخوة, try to use the story of Adam and Eve as a guiding star for you once it comes to these issues. You know, subhanAllah, Satan disobeyed Allah. صحيح؟ صحيح؟ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to bow down to Adam. What did he do? No. I'm not going to do it. Adam disobeyed Allah. صحيح ولا لا؟ مش عصى آدم ولا لا؟ Do not eat from the tree. He did what? What made the difference between Satan and Adam? What? الاعتراف بالذنب. Confessing that you're weak. يا رب, I'm so much involved in mortgage and usury. يا رب, it's حرام. يا رب, I'm weak. يا رب, I'm weak. Help me out. This is what Adam did. ربنا ظلمنا. I'm wrong, يا رب. I'm wrong. بس Satan, this what? Why didn't you bow down? أنا خير من. I'm better. Man, this guy is talking about usury. Usury is international system now. What, this guy is coming out of the moon? This guy doesn't belong to this world. The whole world now is usury. I mean, look at the capital system. We can't even live without usury. Even in Muslim countries, man, there are usury all over the place. Mercy. Mercy, mercy. That, you see the two attitudes? He's resenting it. But the other one is weak. I'm sorry, Ya Rab. سامحني يا رب. Help me come out of it, Ya Rab. Help me. One last thing before I go, and I really mean it this time.
مسألة المذهب يا إخوة. There are a lot of Muslims who are followers of certain school of thoughts. They were brought up with it. هو مالكي حنفي شافعي حنبلي أبو حنيفة وإلا. He's so tuned into the madhab. And when you tell him the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said this, which goes against his madhab, be careful. I'm going to say, I'm not going to accuse anybody of this here, but be careful not to resent this. I'm telling you, even if you still want to stick to your madhab, even if you still want to stick to your madhab, but be careful, don't ever resent what the messenger said. Because at the end of the day, you're required to follow the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all the imams, it was documented that they said this. إذا Abu Hanifa himself, rahimahullah, he says, إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثُ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. If the hadith is authentic, then this is my madhab. Listen. If you want to stick with your madhab, that's fine. You can do this. I'm not saying that you have to change. But don't resent قال رسول الله because it contradicts your madhab. Don't resent it. Be careful. Huh? Huh? Which one? لا تبغض قال رسول الله. Don't resent قال رسول الله because it goes against your madhab. With this, inshallah, we have completed the fifth nullifier. بإذن الله تعالى, this Sunday, I will be in Canada, Toronto, يعني, sharing the knowledge there in Masjid صلاح الدين for the weekend. So next Wednesday, inshallah, we'll talk about the sixth nullifier. And don't forget the seventh nullifier. You know, it's very interesting. It's going to be what? Sorcery. We're going to talk about magic and sorcery. But to be able to attend the seventh nullifier, you have to attend the sixth nullifier. جزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين.